There was obviously a process of almost a year, and it started in Detroit. I was commissioned there to do a project, which is basically a crashed city. So you build up this huge system, and then the factories, you know, they move out, and then somehow the whole city implodes. And we were fascinated by how does that work. Then we thought, well, that's a really nice counterpart if you look at Detroit, and then if you look at Suomi Magazine, which is the same age, basically. I mean, when Detroit emerged, immediately on the other side of the world, Suomi came up, because the garbage of this part ended up there. You know, like a stereo, they belong to each other somehow. But why is this one still running and that one dropped dead? Well, that's the point where we started. Like, okay, let's research that. Well, and then let's say the artistic intervention comes to my mind, like, okay, well, let's do something. Huh? And then the most obvious thing is, why don't we order a car? Because if you order a car and they have to build it, then you go from one shop to the other, because you need tires, you need rims, you need windscreens, and then we can follow the trail as if it's an assembly line. And by doing that, you will know on the end how does it work. And it was a very effective way by just being a client, because clients are always welcome. So if you go to a shop and you pay for something, then it's a transitional relationship, which is very clear. The best thing would be not to design it, but just start building, because we learned that all this waste, which comes into Suomi Magazine, you can easily build a car out of it, but what you cannot do is plan ahead what kind of waste is coming in. So that became the concept, a non-design car. Basically, what comes in, you use. And that's why I tried not to make a drawing, because once you make a drawing, you basically fix, you know, some point on the horizon. It has to be this. And that became really difficult, because everybody wanted to have a vision, like, well, what will it look like? So after a month, I finally said, okay, let me make a drawing, but then it became this. It's a boy's dream, to build your own car. So a lot of people can refer to it. So from day one, there were journalists from the local radio asking, oh, you know, what's it going to be? And so from day one, people liked it. But during the 3 months we were building it, it really went viral, as we say, but then in a low-tech way, because it was on the local radio and then the newspapers, and then it became a nationwide story, like, oh, Suomi Magazine is building a car. So on the end, also the king of the Ashanti region, so let's say the king of Ghana, also heard about the story. And once he came in, then the whole project, you know, became really like a national effort. In Ghana, the whole atmosphere was about hope and about, hey, we have a new concept here, and you know, this can be the beginning. And then the car was shipped to Europe, and obviously to the Netherlands. And let's say after 1 month, it was on national radio, on national television, and then immediately it became an art project, because obviously there was no industry behind it, but an artist and a scientist. So then the story flipped around, like, okay, what is this? You know, is this art? Is this so the story started all over again, but then in a complete different constellation. So now the car is back in Suomi Magazine, and it's maintained by the Smido organization. And around them, let's say all these stakeholders from Kumasi came together to see, okay, how can we connect, let's say, the university to the local mechanic community, but also to the vocational training programs, which are also in Ghana, to see if it could be a master apprentice and school project in one.